Nameservers are an integral part for a domain name, as along with defining the zone file for a particular domain, it also allows you to give your identity to it. Generally, nameservers provided by OrderBox are partially branded, which refrains you from giving a personalized touch to your business. In this video, we'll go through the process of how you can brand your OrderBox nameservers. To create branded OrderBox nameservers for your reseller account, you need to log into your reseller account, then go to Settings, Branding Settings, click on Nameservers. Once you click on Nameservers, you see two sections. The first one is to use partially branded nameservers, and the second one is to use fully branded nameservers. If we wish to use fully branded nameservers, we need to select the second option. Now, before we select the second option and go ahead and add our fully branded nameservers, we need to complete two steps. The first one is creating chain nameservers, and the second one is creating glue records, also known as A records, for the child name servers. To create child name servers for your branded name servers, you need to go to the overview page for the domain, click on products, list all orders, click on the domain name with which you want to brand your name servers. On the overview page under domain registration, click on child name servers. Here you need to create 16 child name servers. You'll get the records for your name servers from the setting options. By clicking on Settings, Branding Settings, Name Servers, here you can see 16 different IP addresses in 4 sets. The first set of 4 different IP addresses is for your first name server. So copy the first IP address and again go back to the overview page of the domain. Click on child name servers. Similarly, I need to do this for the remaining 3 IP addresses. For that, I'll go back to Settings, Branding Settings, Name Servers, copy the second IP address, and repeat the same process again here. Repeat the same step for the remaining child name servers. You need to add 4 IP addresses for ns1.domainsfordemo.com, 4 for ns2.domainsfordemo.com, 4 for ns3.domainsfordemo.com, and 4 for ns4.domainsfordemo.com. Once you've added the 16 child name servers, now you need to create glue records, also called the A records, for the child name servers that we just created. Now to create these A records, we have to log into the DNS zone of the domain or the DNS zone where the domain is currently pointing to. If the domain is pointing to the default name servers of your reseller account, you can just scroll down to the Manage DNS section and add the A records here. To check if the domain is currently pointing to our default DNS zone, you just can scroll up to the Domain Registration section, click on Name Servers. Here you see that the domain is currently pointing to the partially branded name servers mentioned in the Branded Name Server section. Just scroll down to Manage DNS section. Click on Manage DNS. Now here you need to add 16 A records for the 16 child name servers created. To add the A records, click on A records. Type NS1 in the host name. And enter the first IP address. Again, click on A records. Type NS1 again. And enter the second IP address. Repeat the same process for all the 16 child name servers that you have created. Once you have created the 16A records, go back to the branding settings section. Click on Use Fully Branded Name Servers. Select I have created child name server records with all the IP addresses stated below. Select I have created A records with the set of IP address. Once you select both the option to add your branded name servers will be available. Enter ns1.domainsfordemo.com, ns2.domainsfordemo.com, ns3.domainsfordemo.com, and ns4.domainsfordemo.com. Once you have entered all the four branded name servers, click on Update. This will complete the branding of name servers for your reseller account. Once you have added the child name servers and A records, it will take 4 to 6 hours for the records to propagate globally. After this, you will be able to use your branded name servers to point your domains to the default DNS zone. For more such videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Twitter and Facebook.